exactly what the pictures depict. It was important to separate those that were criminal acts and those things that were not criminal acts. That's what the prosecution would have to focus on. If somebody was physically injured, you know you have a criminal act. Putting somebody into sexually humiliating positions, you have a criminal act. Making them abuse themselves sexually, you have a criminal act. Standing by and watching somebody hit their head on a wall and taking photographs at the time, that's dereliction of duty, so it's a criminal act. The individual with the wires tied to their hands and standing on a box, I see that as somebody that's being put into a stress position. I'm looking at it thinking they don't look like they're real electrical wires. Standard operating procedure. That's all it is. Does this one actually constitute a crime, or is it standard operating procedure? That's probably standard operating procedure. The panties on the head are an added touch, but it's no more than sleep deprivation. They weren't being tortured, per se. They were going through discomfort to try to aid in obtaining information. I've been in the Army for 20 years. I've been to Desert Storm 1. I spent 4 months at Guantanamo Bay. People that haven't been where I've been, I can't expect them to see the pictures in the same way.